Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God is very good. Amen. In midst of every obstacles and hindrances that we find, we face, God is still being so good. So let us continue to rest upon His promises and live a life of blessing. Praise the Lord. We are going to start a new series for this month, and this will, I believe, encourage every one of you, and especially these words will bring comfort and confidence and increase our faith in Him. And the theme for this month series that we are going to meditate is, do not worry. What is that? Do not. Say to the person next to you, do not worry. Before we go into the Word of God, let's all take our Bibles and say it together by faith. This is God's Word. And what the Bible says that I am. I have what the Bible says that I can have. In Jesus' name, I will do what the Bible says that I can do. My heart is receptive to God's Word. Today, I'll be blessed through God's Word. I'll be enthusiastic to listen. Encourage, help my pastor preach well. I will never be the same again. Amen. Do not worry. It's not worth it. Let's turn our Bibles to Matthew chapter 6. This passage is one of the most familiar passages in the Bible. Anybody who does not know this, everyone knows this very well. I will read verse 25. Let's look into our Bibles. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more important than food, and the body more important than clothes? Worry is the most common thing that we all know, and I believe, I hope that we are all well experienced in what? In worrying. How many of you can confidently say, I never worry at all? I have no worries in my life. Anybody is there? If at all we get some degrees on worry, who can get the best? Who will be the topper? All of us can. Because worry is one of the most common thing, a common word that everybody knows. And the most difficult task is to not to worry. It's the most difficult task. But to handle this worries and not to worry, let us see what Jesus is trying to teach us today through His Word. Let's directly go into the scripture. Verse 25 of Matthew chapter 6. The first portion says, therefore, I tell you. Everybody say, therefore, I tell you. Who is saying this? Jesus is saying this. Who is saying not to worry? Jesus is saying not to worry. If I tell you not to worry, that means it is worrisome. It is God who is saying not to worry. Hallelujah. Amen. Who is our God? He's a creator. He's a sustainer. He's a mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He is a protector. He is a provider. He is Savior. He is living. He is powerful. He is the one who has carried us from our mother's womb till this day. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. He is telling us not to worry. So, that means there is something in that, that we can be without worrying. God is not telling, please try to be without worrying. Jesus is not saying, I think you can be without worrying. Jesus is commanding. It's an order. Say everybody, it's an order. Do not worry. I tell you, I am saying. A boss says in his office to his people, those who are under him, I am saying you do it. A father tells his children, Appa solre, father is saying you do it. Hallelujah. So Jesus is saying, I tell you. Since the person who said it is powerful, obeying and following that will make a big difference in our lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because based on the person is the value of the word that person speaks. Amen. Hallelujah. A person is measured by his words. A person is measured by the words he keeps. If God has kept his words, all the other words, and if he has ordered us, do not worry, that means he is the one who will help us not to be worrying. Amen. Is that a good news? Hallelujah. If a politician says, we have to be worried actually. Because their words is today and tomorrow different. Why just politicians? Just check you and me. Let's just check ourselves. How confident are we in what we say? Does our words carry weight? But the words of God carries a lot of weight because He's a powerful God. If He says, I tell you, do not worry. Means, do not worry. He that is in us is greater than he that is in the world. The one who is greater in us is telling us not to worry. Means, do not worry. Therefore, I tell you, what is Jesus telling? Do not worry. When a sentence begins with a therefore, that means what? Before that, something is there, some conversation, some talk has been going on of what Jesus is trying to tell here. Not just Jesus, and just for any other matter. No, even when I say therefore, henceforth, so. So what is Jesus trying to tell here? Look the passage before. What was Jesus trying to say before, which made him say, therefore, do not worry. If you see in verse, from verse 19 to 24, see verse 19 to 24, that passage is talking about the treasures in heaven and the treasures on the earth. Verse 19, it says like this, do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourselves treasures in heaven where moth and rust do not destroy and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart is also. Jesus is simply trying to say, we people are worried that we have not stored up treasures on this earth. That is our main concern. That is our worry. When children grow up, we calculate next 10 years. In next 10 years, marriage is going to happen. What to do? Savings are illiye. Once you are finishing your 10th and 12th and graduation, a thought will come upon in your head. What am I going to do? What job will I get? So the concern of people, the worry of people was that ayyo, I have not stored up any treasures on this earth. So Jesus was trying to talk to a group of people who were worried that they had not stored up treasures on the earth. How many of you have treasures on this earth? Does it worry us or not worry us? So Jesus is talking to you and me. Jesus is talking to you and me, telling, you're all worried because you have not stored up your treasure. So therefore I tell you, don't worry. That's why Jesus is saying. Instead, he is showing us an option that you have to be worried that you have not stored up your treasures in heaven. So the difference between the treasures on the earth and the treasures in heaven, Jesus is saying, the treasures that you are thinking of storing up a treasure which is temporary, which is perishable, which easily can be coveted by others, that thieves can come and steal, and you are worried about all that. If you buy one packet of milk, how long does it stay in summer? Maximum a day, even if you keep in the fridge. We are worried that we are not able to buy half a liter packet. Veru chinna packet thanaala vaanga mudiyadhu kavale kettu pora paalukku yenpa kavale padringa vaangama irundha nalladilla appdi solrar. You invest in stock market. We'll talk in your language. You're all big people. We invest in stock market. Who can predict the stock market? We put 1,000 rupees today. Tomorrow when you open, it will be 30 rupees. 100 rupees. 200 rupees. You have lost. And we are worried that we have not invested in stock market and my friends are investing. We are worried that I don't have a bike that that person has. நம்மகிட்ட இருக்கிற இந்த பேஷன் உயிரை ஒண்டா 60 கிலோமீட்டர் கொடுக்குத, அது நல்லது. மற்ற பைக் வாங்கினா ஸ்பீடாக போகலாம், ஸ்பீடாக ஃபியூல் கூட. பட் ஐ எம் வரி தட் ஐ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் அ பைக் லைக் தட். ஸோ ஜீசஸ் இஸ் சேயிங், டு நாட் வரி அபவுட் த திங்ஸ் தட் யூ கேன் ஸ்டோர் அப் ஹியர் ஆன் திஸ் அர்த் விச் ஹேஸ் அ டெண்டன்சி டு பி டிஸ்ட்ராய்ட். And I actually use a very beautiful this verse is. Look at now, verse 25. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life. And Jesus is giving a description about life there, of what people are thinking. What's the description of life? Eat, drink, the body what you will wear. So we have set a boundary for our life. Yeah, life on the That's all my life. We have put a very small circle for our life. That is a problem. And we are worried about that. Life is more than what you think. Is not your body more than what you think? So Jesus is asking. எதுக்காக வேலை செய்றோம்? What are we working for? Nicely we want to eat. Nicely we want to dress. And nicely we want to keep our body. Nicely we want to make ourselves look clean. And we need to get all that that is possible for these three things. Eat, sleep. And when we are not able to afford what we want, that's when the worry begins. If you're able to understand what I'm saying, Hallelujah, correct thane? Only when we are not able to afford what we want, worry begins. Because we have put a circle for our life that my life is all about eating, drinking. அவங்க பாட்டு அந்த ஹோட்டலில் போயிட்டு ஷவர்மா சாப்பிட்றாங்க 150 ரூபா. நான் ரோட்டோரமாக இருக்க 10 ரூபாய் பரோட்டா சாப்பிட்றேனே, என்னால் அதை சாப்பிட முடியலையே. எனக்காவது ஒரு நாள் வாழ்க்கையில் ஐ ஹாவ் டு கோ டு தட் பிளேஸ் அண்ட் ஈட். வரி சாத லிப்ஸ்டிக் 50 ரூபா. லாக்மே லிப்ஸ்டிக் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் லாக்மே லிப்ஸ்டிக் ப்ரைஸ்? மேட்டு கார்பெட்டு 750 ருபீஸ் இருக்குமா ஒரு லிப்ஸ்டிக்? நாலு அது வாங்க முடியலையே. ஏன் லிப்ஸ்டிக் ஒரு நாள் ஒரு மணி நேரத்தில் அழிஞ்சு போயிடுது. பெட்டர் தட் யுவர் லிப்ஸ்டிக் டிஸப்பியர்ஸ் இன் அன் அவர் தேன் ஸ்டேஸ் 8 hours. நிறைய கெமிக்கல் டேஞ்சர், கேன்சர் வந்துடும். Don't be worried. So, you understand what I'm trying to say? Only when we are not able to afford those things that we want, that's when worry begins. Because the world has taught us where we live. It has taught us life of comparison and competition. The world has taught us to live based on comparison and competition. Everybody say comparison, competition. What others have, I don't have. What others do not have, I must have first. Comparison and competition. Israelites had this problem. Numbers chapter 11 verse 5. And if you read this verse, you will only laugh. Look at Numbers chapter 11 verse 5. I will read it for you. Meanwhile, the rebel among them had a strong craving for other food. Again, the Israelites wept and said, "Who will feed us meat?" And look at this verse 5. We remember the fish we ate freely in Egypt, along with the cucumbers, melons, leeks, onions, and garlic. But now our appetite is gone. There is nothing to see but this manna. No. What did they eat, it seems, in Egypt? டேட் ஃபிஷ் சைட் டிஷ் என்ன? சைடில் சாலட், கியூகம்பர் சாலட். அண்ட் போஸ்ட் தட் வி ஹேட் ஃப்ரூட் அண்ட் தென் வி ஹேட் லீக்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் ஆல்சோ வி ஹேட் ஆனியன் அண்ட் கார்லிக். என்ன ஒரு டேஸ்ட்டு ஒவ்வொரு நாளும். வர் தே ஈட்டிங் லைக் தேட்? வர் தே ஈட்டிங் லைக் தேட்? தே வர் நாட் ஈவன் ஹேவிங் டைம் டு ஈட். தே வர் நாட் ஈவன் அலவுட் டு ஈட் ஃப்ரீலி. அண்ட் தேர் லீவிங் அ கதை ஹியர் சேயிங் வி வர் ஈட்டிங் ஆல் தேட் தென் வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் நத்திங் பட் மன்னா. And manna was a food that angels ate, Bible says. Hallelujah. Such a precious blessing they were not able to recognize. Sometimes when we do not recognize the blessing that we have, we crave for the blessing that we did not have and we make false confessions about ourselves and we get worried and we start complaining. Ippo namak irukkira aashirvaadame evlo periya blessing. Hallelujah. How many of you are blessed in Christ Jesus? Amen. Do we know that we are so satisfied eating 3 meal a day that there are several million children who do not even have 1 meal a day? They pick from the garbage and they eat. But God's grace and provision is so much so that we complain that we do not have. So I am saying, when we do not realize the value of the blessing that we have, we begin to worry and complain on God. 1 Samuel chapter 8. They have a problem here. What's the problem? A problem is they need king like other nations. They're going to Samuel and saying, "Pa, you became grandfather and I don't think your children, they cannot, there's no use. Well, do one thing. Before you die, get one king for us. We need a king." Had they told, "We need a king," it would have been good. But they said, "We need king like other nations." Comparison. I want to be like them. Samuel told God, and God was so hurt. And God said, "You know what? They have been doing like this for a long time. They rejected me and they have also rejected you, the prophet that I have appointed over them. And now they want king like others. You better go warn them what will happen if they have a king." And Samuel tells a list of everything. If a king comes, what would happen? Read that chapter, you will know. And people did not listen to the warnings. And they said, "Whatever it may be, we need king and we want to be like other nations." And that's when the problem started in the life of the people of Israel. They were taken into idolatry. They were taken into all kinds of sins. The kingdom was divided. In our lives, when we are not satisfied with what we are, when we try to compare ourselves with others and become like others, we will fail to become even who we are. Teens irukkira periya problem enna theriyuma? Peer pressure. When I was a teen, peer pressure was a term that was used of my age group. But now, post 20 years, post 25 years, peer pressure is among everyone. Peer pressure is among everyone. You agree what I say? The pattern of life the world has set is the newest of the phone, newest of the laptop, newest of the specs 2, newest of the car, newest of the bike. Anything that comes first should be with me. That is a pattern that the world has set. What I'm saying is right. Hallelujah. They want to possess all that, but we don't understand that if we have that kind of a sense, we don't understand that greediness has possessed us rather than we possessing those things. Greediness. The perspective of life must change. Hallelujah. The perspective of life must. Everybody say, the perspective of life must change. We have to start looking at life in a different way. It's like, I'm content with what I have. Contentment. Hallelujah. The perspective of life must change. Everybody say, the perspective of life must change. Do you understand? Have you realized, after earning these many years, after working these many years so hard, 5 years, 6 years, 3 years, 4 years. We have been trying, and you have seen your parents work hard, trying, setting targets, and still not able to achieve those targets means what we have been thinking is wrong. All that I think and I want to have, if I have not able to have, it is not going to be possible that way. So my perspective of life is going in a wrong direction. I have to change it. Yes or no? Is it wrong to be rich? Is it wrong to have expensive things? Is it wrong to be luxurious? But if it is not in your reach, desiring to get that is wrong. Today we will see how do we handle our worries. Everybody listening to me? Amen. Is it all clear so far? Okay, but how should we overcome our worries? If we have to overcome our worries, if we have to handle our worries, if we have to be without worrying, simple things, go to the one who has told, don't worry. What to do? Go to the one who has told, you only told me, no, not to worry. Then tell me what I should do. God just does not give hints for the problem, but he also gives solutions for the problem, for he himself is a solution for all our problems. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33. It's a promise that Jesus is giving in 6 verse 33 part 2. We'll read from the first part. But seek ye first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things shall be. And all these things, everybody say, all these things shall be. What are all these things? All these things that we are worried about. All the kinds of food that we are not able to eat that we are worried about. All the kinds of clothes that we want to wear that we are worried about. All these things shall be added unto you. Say to the person next to you, all these things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. So it is a promise that he has said that he will give you. So when he has said don't worry, he is saying don't worry, I will provide. Amen. Do you have a need today? I'm asking you seriously. Do you have a need? Is there any need that should be met tomorrow? God will provide. Lift up your hands and say, Lord, thank you because you have met my need. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's a promise that he will give you, and he will provide everything that you know, food, clothing, shelter. Father in heaven provides. What is the guarantee? He will provide anything. You know, guarantee namak venume. What is the guarantee? God's word is a guarantee. What is the guarantee that you said now that your need will be met? Your faith, by faith you said. What's the assurance for your faith? There should be something that your God should have told you. 26, verse 26. Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and the heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? You know what's a guarantee? If my God can provide the birds, God will provide my needs. That's a guarantee. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If God can provide the birds that's in the air, God can provide my needs. Clap your hands and glorify God, because your guarantee is God. Are you not better than they? Other guarantee. I am better than the birds that's in the air. I am better than the birds that fly in the air and sit upon the tree. And if my God can provide food, they are not working hard for that. They are not storing up in their barns. They don't have banks. They don't have boxes. They don't have any storage places. Neither do they have to swipe card anywhere. Nor they do have to fear any bosses. God provides or not? God does provide. If God can provide a bird that does not work, does not store, if God can do, God can do it too. God can do it too. Everybody, God can do it to me. Hallelujah. How do birds find food? They use their smell and they use their eyes, vision. And birds also have challenges for eating. If you have a house, in your house a bird came and put its nest, and every day you kept a bowl of water and some grains. And the birds had confidence that somebody is providing me and I am eating. You vacated the house and went. So due to the loss of habitat and because of the things that are disappearing on this earth and all kind of environmental there's scarcity. Winter vandhala avangal paavam paravengalukku saapadu irukadhu in the most difficult parts times of their lives. Yet the Father feeds them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So their dependency is not on the storage. Understand, your confidence and my confidence is not on the bank balance, not on any storage places. Our confidence is on the Father who guarantees our supplies. Because Philippians 4 verse 19, it says like this, "And my God shall meet all my needs according to His riches." Hallelujah. Of His glory in Christ Jesus. Amen. Say it loud. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So that is the guarantee. If God can provide the birds, He can provide my needs also. Number two guarantee. Verse 32. "For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them." Everybody say, "My Father knows that I need them." Already knows that I need them. Amen. Our guarantee of a supply is that He already knows our need. He already knows our hunger. He already knows our desires. He already knows every plans that we have, and He will provide. That's a guarantee because He knows it. Amen. We worship a God who is omniscient, all-knowing God. Matthew chapter 6 verse 8 says like this, "For your Father in heaven knows what you need before you even ask." Amen. God knows everything and all your needs will be met. Amen. We are not talking about big things of life here. We are talking about basic things, food, clothing, shelter, and our basic needs. That's what we are talking about. Do we have all this? Yes, we have all that. We shouldn't think that we already have all it, and why do I need to still depend on God for this? No? Periya periya vishayathukku namba polam. Generally, what the bosses will say, handle small issues with yourself. Bring the big things to me. Right or wrong? You're all grown up and mature, right? Handle small things by yourselves. Major issues, bring it to me. That was an advice given by Jethro to Moses. But when it comes to even the smallest thing of life, just because I have 3 days, 3 meals a day, just because I have enough dress in my wardrobe, just because I have daily needs to be met, already taken care, I don't have financial problem, I don't have a hunger problem, I don't have house problem, I don't have electricity problem, I have no problem in my needs being met, do I still have to depend on God? Is a question here. ஏழைகளுக்கு சுவிசேஷம் சொல்றது ரொம்ப ஈஸின்னு நமக்கு தெரியும். பணக்காரங்களுக்கு போயிட்டு சொல்றது, because for them what is the need? They have everything. சில நேரத்தில் when we have everything in our lives, we forget God. Am I right? So should I have to depend on God even for my daily provision? Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 12 onwards. "I know that there is nothing better for men than to be happy and do good while they live, that everyone may eat and drink and find satisfaction in his toil. This is the gift of God." Say an amen. Hallelujah. We have our daily needs being met without our knowledge. How come that's possible? It's a gift of God. Only when I'm connected to Him, only when I consider that it is given by God, it's not out of my labor. Hallelujah. Are you satisfied with your work that you're doing? Are you satisfied with the food that you're able to eat? It is God that who has given us the ability to work and the blessing to eat and drink and find satisfaction in that. Everybody say satisfaction. It's a gift of God. நிறைய பேருக்கு நிறைய பணம் இருக்கும், காசு இருக்கும், ஆனால் நிறைய உணவு அவங்களால சாப்பிட முடியாதுல்ல. என்ன நினைச்சாலும் நம்ம ரோட்டு உரம்ப போயிட்டு ஒரு போல் சூப் குடித்தாலும் போதும், லோக்கல்லாம் குடித்தாலும் போதும், நமக்கு ஒரு வியாதி வராது. கிஃப்ட் ஆஃப் காட். அல்லேலூயா, ஆமென். Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 18 to 20. Do not forget that it was I who provided water, food and made you all grow and survive the wilderness. I tested you to make you humble so that you will not say that you got this by all your might. What should we not think that we got it by all our might? The food that we eat, the water that we provide, and the growth that we have, the ability to survive, it is not by our might, it is God. It is God who has given us. Say an amen. That's why we need to depend on Him. That's why we need to say, God, I depend on you for my daily needs. And you see this. But it is God who gives you might to earn wealth. And I like this. It is God who gives you strength to earn each day and to eat well. That's why we need to depend on God. Hallelujah. Brother, I am not worried, brother. I have everything. But we still have to depend on God because it is God who gives us. Are you following me? Unless God provides, we cannot have it. Because everything that comes to us has a long process. The farmer has to sow it, God has to send the rain, and it has to be harvested properly, and the government has to fix proper prices, and we should have sufficient money to buy and eat. Don't you know the challenges that we go through for a small cylinder that we buy for everyday cooking? It's all challenging. It is God who has to strengthen us. Because God is the one who gives the farmers to sow the seeds. 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 10. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. Farmer ku seed kudukkuradhu yaaru? Andavar dhaan. God is the one who gives the seed to the farmer. So when it goes to even to the first point of the food production, cycle of food production, and the ability to purchase the food and eat, it is all from God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If God does not interfere in this process, we will not have anything. That's why we have to depend on God. Amen. Hallelujah. How many of you understood so far what I said? I will give 3 practical tips and we will close. What I told before was spiritual tips. Now let me give a practical tip that you can apply in order to overcome your worries. 3 simple practical tips. Always compare your needs with the abundance that is there in heaven. Always compare your needs with the abundance that is there in heaven. And as I already told, always be sure that God knows. Number 3, always be sure that you are greater than birds. Compare your needs with the abundance in heaven. Believe that God knows your needs already. Be sure. Always be sure that you are greater than the birds. If their needs are met, even my needs are met. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God is so good, and I believe that God will meet all your needs. Let's cast away all our cares and worries upon God, because He is all sufficient and He will take care of all my needs and all your needs. If you believe, say an amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give God the glory and say, Lord, I believe that all my needs are met in your name.